Penn State won the toss. They deferred to the second half, and so Tennessee will be receiving the opening kickoff. Coming into the ball game, Penn State with a record of the regular season of 10-2. They are ranked sixth in the country. Tennessee's record is 9-2, and they are ranked 10th. Penn State is 6th. Tennessee is 10. Greg Fayak will be kicking off for Penn State. Dale Carter, who led the nation in kickoff returns last year, is the deep back. He fumbles it at the one. He fumbles it again. There's a scramble for the ball. Penn State has it.
...22-20 in a turnover ratio, first in the nation. Penn State, a very opportunistic team.
Zaka hands off to Anderson, and he goes to the 7-yard line. Sam Gash is the remaining back. McDuffie and Ingram, the wide receivers, and Zaka is dropped back at the 10-yard line. The offensive line for Penn State: Pickett, Jarek, Huntington, Malinowski, and Seaver. Backs and receivers: Zaka, Gash, Anderson, Smith, McDuffie, and Brady. Terry Smith did not draw the starting assignment. He has a shoulder problem. It's McDuffie and Bobby Ingram in the ballgame at the beginning. Third down, 10-yard line. Play action fake. Zaka has pressure, drops it over the middle to Gash. Touchdown, Penn State. Point is up, and it is good by Craig Fayak, and the score is Penn State 7 and Tennessee nothing. As he's looking directly into the sun, you can also tell from the shadows on the field, and of course Ahmad told us about that. And he takes this from a yard deep in the end zone, and he's now out to the 10. A little cut, he's through at the 20, the 25. Comes over the top of the 30, the 32-yard line. Defensively, for Tennessee, it'll be Daphne, Mislinski, Fisher, Stowell, and Lenore on that offensive line, with Kelly, Brunson, Stewart, Faulkner, Pickens, and Adams, the backs and receivers. Andy Kelly is the quarterback. And Tennessee opens up throwing, going to their streak. With the fumble. Gain of 23 yards on the play and a first down for Tennessee. And here they come again. The quick out far side. And it is going to be complete. Humphreys had the coverage on McCleskey as we check Penn State's front seven with Jackson, Dieter, Benfati, Gibbons, Wright, Goganis, and McKenzie. And in the secondary, Humphreys, Bonna, Perry, and Rubin. After that gain of 6 to the 36-yard line. With pressure, the pass is incomplete. Fleming, Kelly has hit 2 out of 3 in the ball game for 30 yards. It's 3rd down and 4. And he sets up again and goes deep down the left side and overthrows Corey Fleming.
Oh, nice play.
Kelly with a little pooch kick. Drops inside the 5 and will be down. It is touched and goes into the end zone. And it will be a touchback. Then we'll start from their own 20-yard line. First down. Penn State up by a score of 7-0. And Zaka comes out throwing. The pass is complete to Richie Anderson. We'll check out that defense of Mims, Bradley. They're going to rule it incomplete and bring it back. Surlis and Smith with Hardy, Walker, and Fields, the linebackers. And in that secondary, Lincoln, Miley, Bennett, and Carter. So move it back to the 20-yard line. And we have just over 12 and a half minutes to go opening period. And Penn State out in front by a score of 7-0. Zaka with a screen to Gash, and he drops it. It is incomplete. It will be 3rd down and 10. Zaka with the play action has pressure, and they bring him down. He's a tough man to bring down.
Play?
I am surprised.
Oh,
he sails a beauty. Carter takes it over his shoulder. He drops back to the 30-yard line. Little stutter step back to the 29. Turns around the corner, up the sideline, and he's going to go out.
I think he's
going to
be back in sync now.
Play action fake. And the pass is complete far side from Kelly to McCleskey.
My last chance to show people what I can do. He'll be trying to do that during the course of this game. Charlie?
I think you might. Here is Tennessee's first running play, and it is James Little Man Stewart.
It's okay if I split up with the other guy just so the team wins. Oh, what a guy.
And Tennessee goes back to the air. It is Pickens down the sideline. First down, 23-yard line. Looking right, he comes back throwing left, and it's Pickens again. Second down and two. And now the second running play is the fullback, Mario Brunson. Play selection, two by ground, seven by air. Now they come back to the ground as Little Man Stewart carries. When we were talking with Tennessee with two tight ends on this offensive set. And a little timing pattern into the corner. And he is out of the end zone.
But he knows exactly where the end zone is. He knows he doesn't have that much room. And once the ball goes up, take a look at the feet. He tries to get the left foot down, but it was a good call by the official. The right foot comes up and the left foot goes down.
Instead, he gives to Stewart. And he is going to get to the 1 yard line. They are stretched and down. It is going to be shy by, as you can see, about two.
They're going to run behind Brunson. Brunson and Campbell, they're two fullbacks, 44 and 29.
And instead, he goes with the quarterback sneak, just trying to lean for that 2 3/4 inches. This is the 10th play of the drive. And Little Man over the top has it. James Stewart has the touchdown as Tennessee pulls within one with the extra point to come. Stewart, 4 carries, 19 yards, a touchdown, and Bexford with the extra point, and we are tied at 7 with 8 minutes and 48 seconds of time remaining in the first period. We'll look down on the 21st Fiesta Bowl.
Score a touchdown back and forth all day, and we'll come out on top.
All right, Charlie. You and Todd, we have all the answers down here. Anytime you need something, Dayton and I will be standing by.
Okay. And on the return, this is Shelley Hammond to the 40, the 45, and finally Collard at the 47 or the 48-yard line. And coming over the top is Richie Anderson. He is airborne at the 50-yard line. And here comes the safety blitz. Gash just slips it. But then it is third down and 8. Sack at the throw, has pressure, and he is dropped at the 45-yard line. Third sack for Tennessee.
He broadcasts as well as he's pass rushing, and we'll do a great job.
Here's the kick by Pelkowski. Carter's going to take it at the 1 yard line. He does not like the fair catch. He does like the return. He's out across the 20. Has to step across a couple of players.
We have a dead ball foul. Personal foul. Then the run back. We'll set the stake. Mark off half the distance. It'll be first down.
Tennessee has the ball at their own 11-yard line, but it is first down and 21. And they have 4 wide receivers. It is Pickens again, this time across the 15. And not make an exception in this case.
Now Pickens already has 3 catches.
Well, they may chase him off. He now has 4. Spins loose at the 30 to the 32, 33-yard line. Remember, it was first down and 21 back at the 11-yard line. Stewart through the middle, the 40 to 45-yard line. A gain of 12 at the Tennessee 45-yard line. Look at that total offense. 4 yards for Penn State, 126 for Tennessee. In case you missed the opening, fumble recovery, pick and fumble. Penn State got it and scored. And ball game tied at 7-7. It is second down and 2. Play action. This one is thrown away.
Kelly
has completed 7 of 11. Double lucky numbers, 90 yards, and here is Stewart for the first down. And now Tennessee with 3 wide receivers on the set.
Mr. Stewart is having himself a day.
Second down and long, 4 wide receivers for Tennessee. All alone and dropped. Lloyd Kerr drops the ball. It is a first down at the 15-yard line. End zone, incomplete.
I think that's the way that works. Isn't that right, Todd?
That makes sense to me.
And here is Stewart to the 7-yard line. Great job.
Very talented rider.
11th play of the drive, 3rd down and 3. Kelly, good protect, dumps it off underneath. This one is incomplete. Vexport will be kicking from the 14-yard line, an attempt of 24 yards. Good snap. It is down. It is up. And it is good. And Tennessee has the lead by a score of 10-7 with 1:42 left to go in the first period.
Charlie, that's the closest I've seen in this first quarter. You could say that Penn State stopped the Nittany Lions to make them kick a field goal.
Two bands from across the country competed in the Fiesta Bowl pageant.
And the kickoff to Penn State.
8 touchdowns. That 55 catches is the most in the history of Penn State for a wide receiver.
Zaka throws the pass, is incomplete.
DJ McDuffie, and that's a major loss for Penn State.
Zaka with a play action fake pass is incomplete to the tight end, Kyle Brady. He said he really doesn't call the plays along the sideline, but things are going well. He will pick off the offense and call the offensive play. Gash carries on the draw to the 26-yard line. Helkowski has pressure, gets it off. Carter drifts back, looks into the sun, takes it at the 29. He's to the 30. Good coverage by Penn State. They will stop him around the 31 or 32 yard line. A new side of Joe Paterno. And here is Stewart, Carey.
No defensive tackle or defensive end to stop his thrust, and there it is again.
And this is Kenneth Campbell. Into the first quarter, Tennessee 10, Penn State 7.
Even though Penn State may not be a running team, they've got to establish some semblance of a running game.
With Tennessee, Stewart, the leading rusher, with 65 yards and 10 carries. And the play action this time works to Faulkner and 17 yards passing.
We have holding on the offense, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
And Kelly back to throw it. Good protection. Drops it over the middle to the tight end, Mark Adams.
It's known as the hero.
Tennessee leading 10-7. Play action. Rolling left is Kelly. All the time in the world. Now he gets pressure. Throws back right into coverage, and it is incomplete. Did he catch it? It was Stewart along the sideline, and he caught it over the shoulder. And it is 3rd down and 10. Pushed down to McCluskey. And enjoying, of course, the offense of Tennessee.
It was nice to know to lend one of his jackets to Johnny Majors.
Yeah. And, of course, following the fireworks of Tennessee, this is Pickens down the sideline. And in the ballgame, 5 receptions for 58 yards and a first down at the Penn State 20-yard line. And this one is incomplete. Tennessee leads by 3, 10-7. We're a couple of minutes into the second quarter. And it is incomplete. Kelly rolls, throws into the corner. Again, Martin to center. Julian to home. And Bexford from 37. No good. He misses wide to the right from the 30 for 37 yards away. Tennessee still leads by 3. And going over the top is Richie Anderson.
Penn State in their history.
struggling in this game, 1 of 5 for 10 yards. This is his second completion. This is to O.J. McDuffie, and he has the first down.
Also, he has returned 2 punts for touchdowns.
And Penn State comes back on the ground with Richie Anderson. Sack is taking a lot of time. Now his pressure rolls out to the right. And he's going to step out.
Man, oh man, those look like gravity boots.
Third down and 9. Sack has pressure. And he throws downfield and it is incomplete. Bobby Engram.
No rush, good kick.
Carter drops back, takes it at the 16, drops it, fumbles it again, picks it up at the 11. He's now at the 10. And struggles back to the 19. First down at their own 19-yard line. They lead in the ballgame 10-7. And Aaron Hayden makes his first appearance.
Step behind you there.
What, over your shoulder. And Hayden is cut down by Bonner.
He's 19, for goodness sake. He's fresh legs.
Here's the reason Hayden is in, as he picks up the first down. And number 50, the left guard, Tom Mislinski, will tell you about the way his name is pronounced right after this play. And here is Hayden. He goes out to the 40-yard line. When second down and 5. Hayden with the last 4 carries in a row, now 5 in a row. And he is brought down. Third down and 4. And Hayden is going to be stopped at the 43-yard line. O.J. McDuffie is the return man for Penn State. And a left-footed walk-on freshman kicker. And a good return for O.J. Penn State first down the ball just shy of their 30-yard line, 35-yard line. And Sam Gash, who has scored.
I think, Charlie, the people shouldn't be already mailing the AFC Championship trophy to Buffalo. I think that those teams are going to be very competitive with them.
Here is the screen to Anderson. And he picks up the first down. Just outside the 48-yard line, their own side of the 50. 6.5 minutes time remaining in the first half. Penn State trailing by 3. Sam Gash is nothing there. Penn State rushing 12 carries, a total of 8 yards. 8 yards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it. Shaka goes deep, and it is incomplete. Shaka's pass is incomplete. Stewart scored for Tennessee. They added the field goal. It's 10-7. Tennessee over Penn State, and this one will be allowed to go into the end zone for the touchback. He can return right now. Rodney Gordon has replaced him at that spot. And Kelly rolls and throws, and the pass is complete far side to Craig Faulkner. This Tennessee offense has been virtually unstoppable by Penn State in the first half. And here is Mario Brunson. Stewart is now the tailback, and his offensive set a little fake to a pitch out. Kelly comes back, goes deep, and the double coverage is caught by Pickens.
Oh, what a throw!
And what a catch by Pickens in traffic. And a gain of 28 yards to the Penn State 41-yard line. The second back through is Stewart to the 35. Again, a play action fake. Pickens stops, comes back, and it is incomplete.
He's running the other direction. He has to make a great athletic play to come back, and that's just what he did.
Over the middle, Pickens pulls it down. 25-yard line, gain of 10, first down.
He's done a good job for us, and we wish him Godspeed.
The ball carrier is Bose Phillips. Also a freshman, the third freshman tailback for Tennessee.
Well, we couldn't fight it in court anyway.
Yeah, okay. Picking 7 receptions, 97 yards. And we have just under 3 minutes. The time remaining in the first half as Kelly just kind of struggles.
He's doing okay today.
I would say he is. 15 of 24, 201 yards already. And here is Pickens again. It's fourth down and a couple. Tyoka Jackson. Carl Pickens now has run his total in the first half to 8 receptions, 100 yards receiving. Penn State from their own 18-yard line.
They're going to use a timeout, assuming that Penn State runs the ball.
Second down and 11, a loss back to the 17-yard line.
They've had two running plays, and they've got a net of minus 5 yards.
Third down and 14.
Maybe right half time. We'll get it.
Anderson.
They will not.
I got to tell you, Joe.
Absolutely not.
First down at the 32-yard line. Chaka has pressure, steps away, steps back.
We should just kneel down and get the half over with.
What camera will I have, TR?
Second down and two. The ball just shy of the 40-yard line. And glad that he is healthy and back with it. Chaka with that pressure. The pressure from Chuck Smith.
This isn't happening right now.
Three wide receivers for Penn State. Here is the draw. And there's nothing there. Bradley and Kelly with the tackle as the first half comes to a close. Tennessee 10, Penn State 7. Total offense. First half, 324 yards for Tennessee. A total of only 59 for Penn State. The margin, though, is only 3.
But the look on that man's face says it all. Yeah.
It's 10-7 here at the Fiesta. Tennessee will be kicking off to open the second half with Hammonds and Morris, the two return men. And here is J.T. Morris on the return. And he is decked at the 16-yard line.
The first half, so Penn State doesn't want to give them the ball back, 3 and 5.
And here is Sam Gash, the fullback. Oh, my logic is
not Armageddon just yet.
Tell me what it is. And it is incomplete. Jack and now 5 of 13 for 49 yards. He does have the touchdown throw. Good kick. Carter backpedals to the 24. A right return on as a couple of blocks. And it's spun down at the 32, maybe the 33-yard line.
Now if Tennessee drives the length of the field and scores, I'll come back to you and say you were right when you said it was a 9 on the Richter scale.
Kelly's pass is complete to Faulkner. It does not like to be called a possession type. I'm a quick speed receiver.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Third down and one. Mario Brunson. Kind of form fitting.
Yeah.
Play action. Flag is down. May have a face mask call as Kelly was spinning away.
They finally had him for a big loss.
I guess the defense. 5-yard penalty.
Who had 29.
First down and 5. Here is James Stewart.
Stewart carries.
Size isn't that much of an issue anymore.
And here is Stewart.
The reserve tackle for the Volunteers, Rodney Gordon. If he had his head up, he'd had a few more yards. The offense anyway.
Corey Fleming. 44 yards and the touchdown.
In the mismatch with the inside backer.
And the extra point. We'll be back with the kickoff in a moment.
Tennessee's done a good job of taking advantage of that.
Here is J.T. Morris on the return for Penn State. Across the 20. And up in it at the 30. Leaves the ball on the ground, but they may rule. No, they're going to rule a fumble. No, now they change it. Now trailing by 10, 17-7. With 10:47 left to go in the third, and Chaka back to throw. Bobby Engram. And here is Sam Gash. And the
The defense of Tennessee controlling the ball game, and their offense has been spectacular. And the pressure, as you can see, on Tony Saka, this time by Todd Kelly. Defensive ends of Tennessee, and boy, they have played havoc with them. Nowakowski kicking. Carter takes it at the 15. Wants to get around the corner, does turn it, goes out of bounds. Playing like Jim Kelly, 18 of 29 so far, he's thrown for 256 yards and a touchdown. Now Tennessee with Aaron Hayden, the ball carrier. Play action fake here, reverse to Faulkner. Faulkner to the 40. To the 50-yard line.
He could have had so much more.
They're going to mark it down at the 47-yard line. Total offense now over 400 yards for Tennessee. As Hayden gets the call. And Penn State 7 with 8 minutes left to go in the third. And Kelly's pass is dropped by the tight end Mark Adams. Tennessee sends five out on the pattern. The pass is incomplete. It is low to Pickens.
Averaging over 10 yards of return. He had two.
It's a fake. He had pressure. He ran to the outside. And it wasn't there for Tom Hutton.
Penn State has good field position at the 42. Strange call.
Their second best starting field position in the ballgame following the fumble recovery, the opening kickoff at the 11-yard line. The coverage was there, and that meant five straight incompletions for Tony Saka. And here is Anderson. And there's maybe a yard.
Tennessee has been able to key on Penn State's running game and practically negate it.
Third down. Play action fake, looking for a screen. And it is incomplete for. And he, if you picked out an individual, you'd almost have to say he has had the best game of any of the Penn State.
Well, he definitely wanted to add to his average there. Leading Saka there for the Penn State Nittany Lions with 9.5, but he's been a non-factor today.
Who do you like in that game?
It's going to be very close. I like the way Kansas City has been running the football, and if they can do that.
Good afternoon in Mile High Stadium.
On your offense, 10-yard penalty, still second down.
I'm looking forward to it. I really am.
We're moving on the 6 minute mark, time remaining. We're in the third quarter. The reverse to Faulkner. Not as successful as it was the first time, but third down and 6 for Tennessee. The ball at their own 36-yard line. And Kelly's pass is incomplete. That's right. Here it goes. McDuffie takes it at the 26. He's to the 30, the 35, to the 40. He's to the 50, still on his feet, to the 40. Needed one more block. He goes out of bounds. Inside the 35-yard line.
A big for the Penn Staters at this point.
He's number 41, as you saw there. Saka goes to the end zone, and it is incomplete as he overthrows McDuffie. 7 straight incompletions for Saka. 5 of 19 for 49 yards. Dismal throwing. Here's the screen. And it is dropped.
I was watching him in warm-ups, and he was short from 49.
Flag is down, free play. Pass is complete. McDuffie inside the 20 to 50 to the 8-yard line. Maybe the 7. O.J. McDuffie.
Obviously, he's the guy that's got it going.
Offside on the defense. Penalties declined.
Chip LaBarca has come in as a wide receiver. He's split to the far side. First down and goal to go. LaBarca coming in motion. Anderson to the 4. Second down, goal to go. Gash is the remaining back. Anderson is on the right wing. And it's Gash. Maybe a yard. That's going to be it.
You put it up. This is 4-down territory.
3 wide receivers left side. Backside pressure passes complete to LaBarca.
A little bit confused, LaBarca gets the big opening.
And
And the extra point is good. And Penn State falls back within three of Tennessee, 17-14, with 2:56 still remaining. We're in the third quarter. Carter, the return man. And he will take it at the 11-yard line, out to the 20. And good downfield coverage for Penn State.
Two series for Tennessee have been three and punt. They have to generate something now. Now the onus is on Kelly to get his offense going.
Kelly back to throw, has protection, goes deep, and it is incomplete. He wanted James Stewart, but Tennessee has had four peaks this valley. But right now, the momentum or the next peak has shifted to Penn State. The flag is down on the play. Penn State says they have the football, but there is a marker.
See. And the offense coaches refuse, and it's first down.
And he has brought joy to Penn State, hasn't he?
He has brought joy to that blue and white sideline right now.
Here's the throwback all alone. Is it tight end? Kyle Brady. Point it down. And it is good. 21-17 with 2:29 left to go. And Carter from the 5-yard line. Slips a tackle. And will be down at the 22.
Probably would cause the problem.
And the second back through is Bose Phillips.
Why not go with him now that you're down by four?
Play action fake. It is intercepted. Penn State has the ball. Reggie Gibbons with the interception.
So they've had three turnovers against Tennessee today.
Penn State with a first down at the Tennessee 26. Over the middle, the pass is complete. To the 80-yard line, Troy Drayton, the tight end,
really turned towards Penn State.
And we're still in the third quarter. Anderson to, and a slot on the left side. And it's Anderson to the 5, to the 2-yard line. Well, it'll be third down and goal to go. That is the end of the third quarter. Back after these messages from your local station. Penn State, as you can see, with 14 points in the third. They have always been strong in the first and third. They are again. They start the fourth. Third down, second. End zone. They're going to mark it down just shy. O.J. McDuffie.
And I dare say this is the biggest play of the game.
Over the top is Richie Anderson. Bill Spohr, the holder. And Fayak with the extra point. By the way, Bob Check, the snapper, was the manager. Back in a moment. Carter is set for the return for Tennessee. And he will take it at the 2-yard line, to the 10, the 15, the 20. Hit at the 25, spins out to the 28, maybe the 29-yard line. Kelly is hit, ball is loose. Gibbons, touchdown, Penn State. What a yard it loose. Comes up with it.
Again, number 58, Reggie Gibbons with a big play.
And the extra point is good. It is Penn State 35, Tennessee 17. Whoa, what a change. Yeah.
misses it on the hop at the goal line. Stutter step at the nine. He's in trouble. Back to the five. He's in bigger trouble. Back to the one. Gets around the corner.
We have a dead ball foul. Out of bounds. Late hit. This way going.
Kelly rolling right. Almost intercepted. Put out wide to the near side. Pressure from the backside. And Kelly goes down. Gorgonis got him. Following the Fiesta Bowl.
If that score holds up, rather 21-7, I'll be interested to see. Miami's going to have a big game to maintain the number one ranking.
And here is the screen to Phillips. Man, he said, my job is to avoid the first tackler. And he does. And then is in at the 50.
I would think that Miami would have to have a big victory over Nebraska to maintain their number one ranking.
Here's Anderson to the right side for Penn State. Penn State E.J. Sandusky is now in at right tackle. He, of course, is Jerry Sutton, who is the defensive coordinator. Dash and Anderson are the running back. And it is Anderson to the 36-yard line.
It's very difficult to have continuity if you don't have the same starters week in and week out.
Tackle wanting to go deep. He really wanted to go deep.
I believe it was the Sugar Bowl for the national championship when they ran four times inside the 1 yard line, got stuffed every time and ended up losing. Since that time, maybe they felt compelled to be a little bit more creative.
Here is McDuffie. Touchdown, Penn State. 37 yards. Would you believe this turnaround? Tennessee dominating the first half. It is good. Penn State 42, Tennessee 17. For the victory.
Yep.
Penn State has scored five touchdowns in the last 8 minutes. And here's Carter on the return. Don't let that... Kelly to throw, has pressure, it is incomplete, it'll be second down. And Miami and Nebraska for the national title.
And don't think the Miami players aren't watching the scoreboard. You know that they are.
Kelly just kind of put his hand out. Kelly and it is incomplete. As he overthrows Faulkner, it will be fourth down.
Some 10 minutes left in the game.
So Tom Hutton is kicking. McDuffie the return man, 31-yard line. And O.J. returns. Pennsylvania, the state of Tennessee, will stay with us here until conclusion, and they will join the Orange Bowl as Anderson jumps to the outside and picks up four, maybe 5 yards.
I can't believe it.
Well, it did happen. It is second and five. Penn State in control, 42-17. And here is J.T. Moore, calling us on NBC. Well determined, that national champion. Oh, I... And here is Collins. Jerry Collins, number 23. And the fake. And the pass is incomplete to J.T. Morris.
Okay, I have a point to that after this. Now the bounce is going.
Oh, every bounce goes Penn State's way. Schuler is now the quarterback for Tennessee. Here is Hayden on the left side. Shooter, the freshman.
Simply because they struggled in the second half. I think he's shown the pro scouts a lot in the first half of what he can do.
Here is Hayden again with the call. He'll pick up the first down.
Arguably the greatest quarterback in Tennessee history.
He set all the records. Shuler goes deep, and it is incomplete. Ronald Davis, the intended receiver.
Assume that they're going to be national champions, and Miami defeated them in Miami. Turnabout could be fair play, and I don't know if that's on Nebraska's minds or not, but certainly an opportunity to do it.
Hey, I'm standing, huh? And this will be close to the first down. Oh, I don't fault that guy. Except that's the reason I baffle it. I've got it covered both ways. The pass is high. and Washington over 300 yards in total offense, and Michigan held only 95 yards in total offense so far in the Rose Bowl.
And that's the kind of domination that impresses the voters. And you know what? Not a matter of having been around a long time. He has a winning percentage of 79.1, second only to Tom Osborne's 81%.
Phillips on the receiving end of the pass. Ingram, the freshman from Camden, South Carolina. Getting a little return experience. Flag is down. 1989.
On the receiving team, a 15-yard penalty. First down.
And he needs some work. And Joe Paterno said this. He needs a good year working in the pros with, you know, as a backup or as a number three quarterback. Kerry Collins now the quarterback for Penn State. And here is Shelly Hammonds. And he will pick up the first down. First down. And here is Jerry Collins, the ball carrier. And he's going to pick up about five on the play.
Special thanks to our director, John McDonough. Outstanding
why?
Job this season.
Why is it a special thanks to? Why? And with this victory, as we'll take the countdown of the last few seconds, Penn State's record here in the Fiesta Bowl will be perfect. We said at the top of the telecast that five was the magic number. And we take the countdown now of the last 10 seconds to make it official. The handshake between the two head coaches, I think they wonder about it as much as we do. A big turnaround. Penn State comes from behind second half, wins it 42-17. Don't forget, we'll be going to the Orange Bowl and the national championship.